Hi, I am Seth Rotenberger, and today I'll be showing you how to use Inverse Kinematics in the Animation Designer. Inverse Kinematics will automatically create a motion path for rigid groups to get from a set point to a desired point, which is an easy way to make smooth and seamless animations. I already have all the rigid groups and joints created. We can view the different rigid groups and see which bodies are grouped together and which are separated based on their different colors. We can easily show the joints in the graphic display and see how they are positioned in the assembly. Each of these joints will be used to constrain the motion of the drill press when we use inverse kinematics. Before we use inverse kinematics, let's use Move Rigid Group so we can physically see how the different rigid groups will move around each other and the motion we can get from them. Let's now use the inverse kinematics command to create a motion path. Our rigid group is going to be the drill press spindle, and we can easily select the center of the circle. Our destination is going to be the center point of this hole. The coordinate systems of the starting and destination points need to line up, and an easy way to get this orientation is to select an axis and then a face you want it to reference. The destination point needs to move back a bit to accommodate for the drill bit. We are going to add a second destination point for the spindle to reach after the first one to simulate the drill going through the material. We can now finish this command and then go view the motion path created. That animation looks great, and we can inspect it by opening up the timeline. We can move through the animation to more easily see how the rigid groups are moving. It is clear that the spindle reaches the first destination point and then moves horizontally to the second one, which is what is supposed to happen if it were to actually drill into an object. Let's finish up this animation by making the drill press return to its original position. It is easy to do this by simply selecting all the motion that has already been created and then mirroring it so the drill press goes back the way it came. The final animation now shows the completed sequence of the drill press to fully drilling into the object and returning home. Let's recap what you have seen. You saw me show the different rigid groups and joints in the drill press assembly. I then used inverse kinematics with two destination points to simulate drilling into an object. Finally, I mirrored the motion and viewed the final animation. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.